Is this your first time in Gütersloh?
Actually, I was here already yesterday.
So you're almost native. Yeah, very good.
Almost.
The very first album you recorded in America for Herbie Mann's label was Infinite Search. You were in your mid-20s. Now that's a rather...
No, I was 20.
20? So that's a very prophetic title.
Actually,
at 22, sorry. So maybe almost mid-20s. So, but still, Infinite Search at that time. You know, most people at that time, they think life is infinite search. But you predicted a musical infinite search that we saw is still going on tonight. Did you think 40 years ago that this was really infinite? Or was it more a title like, oh yeah, you know, it's the 70s, we're all very spiritual and searching infinite. Who knows, you know?
No. But, actually, I was looking for title for the album, obviously, and I was very seriously thinking for a long time, and then I actually realized that actually the whole life and everything is infinite search. So that's what I decided to call the album. Just like that.
Die unendliche Suche schon mit 20, 22 oder so. Damals ein eher prophetischer Titel für dieses erste Album in den USA. You spent a lot of time in America. It must have been interesting, at least, you know, coming from a communist country over to Berkeley to meet all these, especially many African-American musicians. I mean, you know, in Herbie Mann's band, you and Herbie were the only white people. Sonny Sharrock, Roy Ayers was there, you know. How was that for you? Did you adapt very easily? I mean, you told me you were really speaking black slang most of the time, but also... musically, was it different with them? Did it come easily?
Well, there's a long story because we listened to a lot of jazz in Czechoslovakia. At the time, there was a Radio Free Europe program. And we received, actually, I heard all the new albums coming out since 1963, 62, 64, 65. Much more than American musicians I have met later on because they were living like in Cleveland, right? So they went to the local store. And they had like 4 or 5 CDs, so they would buy some of those. I heard them all by the radio. So I was actually more educated about the jazz than they were. There was one thing about that which was really surprising for me. The second thing is that it was kind of easy to play with, you know, they accepted me. They accepted me because I was a white boy, but I was from Europe, you know, from Czechoslovakia. So they took me like their own son or something, which was very... kind of them. They were wonderful to me, really, many. Oh, everybody, really, everybody. So it was easy, yeah.
Er kam in den 60ern aus der Tschechoslowakei in die USA, hat dann Berkeley studiert und hat dann mit der Band des Flötisten Herbie Mann lange gespielt, mit vielen großen, vor allen Dingen afroamerikanischen Musikern, Roy Ayers und Sonny Sharrock und viele andere. Und er meint, es war für ihn besonders einfach, weil er diese Musik, diesen amerikanischen Jazz vielleicht besser kannte als viele von denen, weil Willis Conover und die Radiosendung, die damals vor allem natürlich in den östlichen Staaten von den Amerikanern auch zu Propagandazwecken gesendet wurden, weil er all diese Musik daher kannte. Die Amerikaner gingen in ihre lokalen Plattengeschäfte, da waren halt die Local Heroes und die 3, 4 großen Alben, die Columbia vielleicht rausbrachte, aber... all das, was Willis Conover spielte, das wurde dort natürlich aufgenommen und diese Bänder, I think you taped them, right? The shows and the tapes made it from one artist to the next.
A lot of them we taped, yeah.
Also es waren alles Bandaufnahmen, die da eben die Runde machten in der Tschechischen Republik. Now the infinite search, I mentioned, you know, it continues on. It would have been easy. 1 week ago, you released a new album. A completely different band, a completely different setup. I mean, you could have brought them and just said, you know, here's my new album, this is what I do, the music of Weather Report, but you chose to bring a different band.
Actually, the only different guy is the drummer. It's well, enough, yeah.
One drummer, two drummers playing different at the same time. I think that's pretty much a difference.
Yeah, it is a lot of difference, sure, sure. But you know, we play the same kind of music I started playing back then, because the basic difference is that I'm not playing the bass like a bass role, like a bass slave, you know, kind of a thing. I mean, I hate to say that, but in jazz, basically the bass has a role of going boom, 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 boom. It started with a Dixieland in New Orleans with a tuba player who couldn't play the bass. So this is how it came about, that in the jazz, the bass had this role, you know. So I was very lucky because I could play the instrument. And when I came to America, you know, it was not so difficult because they couldn't play the bass, you know. So I was lucky, actually.
Okay, es war also für ihn einfach, weil er tatsächlich den Bass spielen konnte, als er in den USA kam und viele der Bassisten in den USA eben nur bum, 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 bum machten, wie es anfing in New Orleans mit den Tuba-Spielern, die natürlich keinen Bass in der Gegend rumtragen konnten und deswegen die Tuba spielten. Und das ging immer einfacher. Tell us something about the music you're playing tonight. I mean, there's a very searching, if I may say so, quality to it, but a very poetic quality also.
Well, basically we are not searching so much as we are playing like in the waves, like the nature. I don't know, maybe many of you feel this, but it's like the flower grows, you know, the red flowers grows right next to the blue flower and it's okay. They have no problem, you know. So we try to play like that, naturally. And also what we hear, what the music which comes to us, what we hear. So it's not so much searching. Basically, we hear it, you know. But yes, and of course, the big element in it is that I'm not playing the bass role. So this is what brings about much different music, because they have to, I insist, conversation from the other instruments. And we do it. Like we did this in Weather Report. This is where it started, right? And so immediately the music becomes quite different because it goes out of the jazz scene and it goes into direct conversation. And then we play together, the harmony and all that. You could tell many times that we get the same ideas with the piano player here, you know, how the harmony comes and how it goes and how it floats, you know, nice. And a great communication. It's all about communication and conversation.
Interplay, like the song
yes.
you wrote.
Yeah. Right. Interplay.
Meine Damen und Herren, und deswegen geht es jetzt weiter mit der Musik, über die wir jetzt schon viel zu lange geredet haben. Die Miroslav Virtuoskop. Miroslav, thank you very much.
Thank you.